See here, one devotee, Malati Dasi, she asked Prabhupada, in the beginning we were curious about how to chant. What do you do when you chant? And what do you think? See, very right question has been asked to Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada, what I should do when I chant? And what should I think when I chant? You ask Prabhupada these two questions. Of course, we already know the answer because we have heard so far what Prabhupada wants. Prabhupada said two things. What did he say? You don't do anything, you don't think anything. Look at that. You simply hear, Prabhupada is saying. You simply hear. Hearing is so important. You don't do anything else, you don't think anything else. Don't do anything else, don't think anything else. That's what it means. You simply do chanting and hear. Hear, do chanting and hear. Don't do anything else. Don't think anything else. This is the secret which we are now trying to practice. So small difference between chanting and chanting come thinking japa and chanting come hearing japa. Chanting come thinking japa is simply a yantra japa. No spirit in it. No mind even in it. Chanting come hearing concurrently is mindful japa. Chanting come hearing delightfully with hope, with relish, with hope, with excitement. I'm not saying you jump and get excited, but a micro excitement, micro pleasure. It's a peaceful, sattvic excitement. The sense of feeling that Lord is with me and I have been able to serve Him one more bead. I am able to please my spiritual master one more bead. Prabhupada asked, what is it that pleases you most, Srila Prabhupada? Everybody thought book distribution or this thing or that thing and so many things. Prabhupada said, what pleases me most is when you chant Hare Krishna. Look at that. This is a real acharya. Transcendental pleasure to the Lord. You take His holy name, that is most pleasing to me. So therefore we should feel that I am pleasing Prabhupada. That is another feeling you can get. I am pleasing. If you please a pure devotee, then Krishna is more pleased. So the first part, don't do anything, don't think anything, is called vikalpa. You need determination, a mind slice to keep aside all these things, which you automatically, we have now, last 30 days, we have prepared that. But every time bringing it mind back, we already created one barrier for this to go. That is vikalpa. That means keep the negative forces away. And then put the energy on the positive energy on the where you have to put. Keep away negative forces and give positive forces. Keeping away negative forces is called vikalpa and this is sankalpa. So we have sankalpa to only chant and hear each nama. Chant, hear and task and nothing else. Do nothing else, task nothing else. Like that we should be. That is sankalpa. And vikalpa, which we have already trained, is by training a mind slice that whenever it goes, it will bring back again chesta into this nama. So actually, it's a combination. Mindful japa is a combination of two mind slices that we have trained. One that keeps away. Whenever the mind goes away, fresh mind is put on chanting and hearing. This is the mind slice.